G'day mates, and welcome to this Australia Day special of Wolf and Chef's Clothing. To celebrate this special day in country, we are doing a good old-fashioned sausage sizzle. So let's head outside to the most Aussie of all cooking devices, the barbecue. Preheat the barbie on high before lowering to medium and adding on two beef barbecue sausages. Spray the griddle side with oil before adding on one sliced up yellow onion and season with salt and pepper. Regularly agitate and turn both the onions and snags until they are both browned and cooked through, roughly 8 to 10 minutes. Back inside and we're ready for final assembly. Staying true to tradition, we are placing our snag on a piece of white bread on the diagonal before topping with onions and barbecue sauce. And of course, it wouldn't be a proper Aussie Day feast without your best mate. This right here is pure Aussie perfection and I would never in the world change it. But just for the sake of showmanship, let's see if we can't jazz it up a notch. You know, just to fit the style of this show a bit more. Beginning with our sausages, we are gonna use beef and lamb barbecue, same as last time, only a bit thicker. And to cook this evenly all the way through, we're gonna do them sous vide on the stovetop. Place the sausages in a large Ziploc bag before pouring over some good Australian beer, or VB, and a couple of pinches of salt. We're gonna heat a large pot of water until it reaches 60 degrees Celsius before submerging our bag. Place the pot back on the stove, constantly monitoring, making sure the water maintains a temperature between 60 and 65 degrees Celsius for roughly 1 hour. Moving on to the onions, we are gonna do a quick pickled version. So begin by slicing up one red onion before placing in a sieve and parblanching by pouring over roughly half a liter of boiling water and letting it drain off. In the meantime, let's combine our pickle ingredients, which consists of 1 teaspoon each of salt and sugar, 3/4 cups of apple cider vinegar, 5 or so whole black peppercorns, 1 large clove of garlic, a few sprigs of thyme, 1 dried chili if you want some heat, stir to the salt, and add in all your onions. Give it a quick stir just to make sure everything is uniform. Pop the lid on and let it sit for 30 minutes. Next up is our barbecue sauce, of course made from scratch with a few key Aussie ingredients. In a small saucepan, add roughly 1 cup of tomato passata, 1.5 tablespoon of molasses, couple of tablespoons of ketchup, 1/4 cup of apple cider vinegar, tablespoon and a half of Dijon mustard, 1 large clove of garlic, pressed, teaspoon each of oregano, sweet paprika, and vegemite, of course, to add some salty savoriness and to make it as Aussie can be. Finally, we're gonna add in a glug of whiskey and half a mango pureed for some sweetness. Start to combine and place on the stove on low heat and let simmer until it thickens a bit, roughly half an hour. Finally, our bread. We're gonna use 2 slices of Viking bread from a previous episode and lightly toast them in some butter over medium heat. By now, our sausages will be done and cooked all the way through, so take them out of the bag and pat them dry using a paper towel. And you may be surprised as to just how good these things feel in your hands. Anyway, we're gonna melt a bit more butter and fry these over medium heat until they're brown on all sides, roughly 3 minutes. Having used this technique to cook the sausages, they are gonna be extremely juicy, as you'll see when we cut across. Now, let's assemble our components and see how our gourmet version of an Aussie classic stacks up. And yeah, I have to say, it's pretty damn good. Happy Australia Day, everyone. May you release your inner bogan. Cheers.